Quick question for you. If your sink is leaking, do you A, call a plumber, B, call a handyman, C, ask ChatGPT and probably get your house flooded? Well, jokes aside, this is exactly how AI works. Some AI models are like handymen, they know a little bit about everything. Others are like specialists, they do one thing and they do it really well. That's where HuggingFace comes in. It's like having an entire library of AI specialists at your disposal where all the tools are open source and free to use. Today, I'm going to show you how it works, why it's so powerful. We'll do a quick demo, and then I'll show you how you can start using it right now. For those new to the channel, I'm Remi Taffin. I'm a software engineer with 15 years of experience building software and diving into the world of AI. On this channel, I break down complex AI topics, share insights, and help you stay ahead of the curve. If you're looking to understand AI, automate your business, and level up your skills, you're in the right place. All right, let's dive in. Okay, first things first. What is Hugging Face? No, it's not really a feel-good therapy session where robots hug it out, though that could be nice. Hugging Face is basically the Home Depot of AI. There's tons of tools, some ready to use, some need to be put together, and some that look useful, but you have no idea what they actually do. Think of it like a massive online toolbox filled with specialized AI models trained to do very specific tasks. It's where developers, researchers, and companies go when they need an AI that's really good at one thing, like translating languages with incredible accuracy, or detecting diseases early, or looking at medical scans, or detecting specific things from images or videos, like traffic lights for self-driving cars, and so on. So why not use ChatGPT for all this? Well, that's where our handyman analogy comes in. Meet ChatGPT, the AI handyman. Need an essay? Done. Want to brainstorm a business idea? There you go. A random fact about otters? Oh, it has thousands.
Did you know that otters hold hands while they sleep to avoid drifting apart?
That's adorable. But here's the catch. Just like a handyman, ChatGPT knows a little bit about everything, but isn't an expert at anything. It can fix your sink, but don't expect it to rebuild your entire plumbing system. It can help you write code, but don't expect it to be this world-class software engineer. And it can explain medical concepts, but don't use it as a doctor. And this is where Hugging Face AI models came in. If ChatGPT is a handyman, then Hugging Face models are the specialist. AI trained to do one thing really, really well. They're also called narrow AI. These AIs don't chat for fun. They don't pretend to know everything. They have one job and they do it flawlessly. In fact, this brings up an interesting AI fact. Did you know that most of the AI-powered tools you already use every day are narrow AI models? Google's search ranking algorithm? Narrow AI. The face recognition on your phone? Also narrow AI. Early cancer detection research? Also narrow AI. These aren't general-purpose models. They're specialist, optimized for speed, accuracy, and efficiency. That's why companies rely on them when precision actually matters. So, when should you use ChatGPT and when should you go for Hugging Face model? If you need a broad, general-purpose AI, ChatGPT is your guy. If you need highly accurate, specialized results, well, Hugging Face is the place to go. But here's the thing: sometimes you need both. Let's say you have an AI chatbot for customer service. You may use ChatGPT for friendly, flexible conversations, but when it comes to processing refunds or checking order statuses, you'll want to have a specialized AI that knows exactly how to do that without making stuff up. That's why a lot of AI systems use a combination of generative and narrow AI, kind of like how you call a handyman for general fixes, but bring in the big guns for specialized work. Another big difference: efficiency. ChatGPT is like a Swiss Army knife, handy, but not the best at any one thing. Hugging Face models are like power tools built for a single job, and they do it way better. Also, ChatGPT is expensive to run because it's constantly guessing and generating and having to know everything about the internet and keeping up with it. Hugging Face models are cheaper, lighter, and faster because they only focus on one task at a time. Now, you might be wondering, will ChatGPT ever be as good as a specialist? The short answer is maybe. AI is evolving insanely fast, and the future models might be able to switch between broad and specialized knowledge in real time. But for now, The best approach is using both, actually. ChatGPT for general tasks and specialist models for precision. Let's dive into a demo. All right, so here's the interface from HuggingFace, and you can see there's a list of tasks here that you could take a look at. There's, at this point, 1.4 million models, so there's a lot out there. But if you want to play around, you could take a look at object detection, depth estimation, text to image, image to 3D. I'm gonna pick a few of those and show it to you right now, but you could play with this for a long time, so feel free to do that. So the first that I picked is Black Forest Labs Flux, which is a text to image. So what I've put in is otters sleeping on a king size bed in the middle of the ocean, and I just ran this. It just spun up for a little while, and this is what it generated. It is really cool, and that came up actually decently fast. So another one that I wanted to take a look at is One AI, which is a text to video. So I wanted to try that. So what I put is a wiener dog wearing a tuxedo walking towards a castle, which is totally random, but this is what it generated. So this is really cool, right? You can see how realistic that is with the sun hitting everything here. It's doing a great job. It just takes some time to generate. So this one took 600 seconds, but it got there. And you can download some of those models and use it for yourself. They're all open source. So this is just incredible to be able to use this. One more that I use is the distill any depth. So this is one where you pass in an image and it actually shows you the depth of the different layers within the photo, which is interesting. It's actually doing a really good job. If you can see here, this is the front. It shows the wheels and is more at the front. And you can have that slider to compare. And then you have the gray depth as well. There are some other photos you can use too. Even for something, you know, that is a sketch, it's actually doing a really good job here. So as I said before, those are very, very specific tasks, but it's doing a very good job at them, and the accuracy is through the roof. Now, hopefully, you understand why companies and developers love Hugging Face. They can grab a specialized model and use it for exactly what they need. No extra fluff, just pure expertise. So next time you need AI, ask yourself, do you need a handyman AI or do you need a specialist AI? And if you want to try these AI tools yourself, check out Hugging Face. It's free, easy, and doesn't require a PhD to understand it. If you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and leave a comment with the coolest models you found on Hugging Face. I'll see you in the next one.